Hello and welcome to Affinity. Here's a way of using a fill layer as in a kind of mask-like way. So to get a fill layer up, we just go to Layer, New Fill Layer, and it comes up as whatever the background mask is, but you can just play around with colours and it will change automatically and quickly, which is great fun when you're using it in some sort of way. For example, you know, if you turn down the opacity, you can add tints, you know, to a picture and so on. However, what you can also do, if I take a paintbrush and I get black brush, now when I paint on it, look, I'm poking a hole through it. It's like I'm using a mask. And if I switch to white, then I can put that back again, whatever the colour is. However, if I try to change the colour now, it doesn't change. Once you've painted on it, you're stuck with the colour that you've got. That's how it is. Okay, let's start again. So here we go. Let's have a fill layer. And let's just get a colour. Yeah, we'll leave it on black. We'll turn off that layer for the moment. Go to the background layer. I'm going to go to the selection brush and I'm just going to select. I've got snap to edges set at the top and I'm going to select this door, alt click to get rid of the bits around the edges. So there you go, there's the door selected. Now then, when I go to my fill layer up here, I've got this in front of this here, so I could change the colour of my fill layer. I can turn down the opacity of it. So I've got a colour thing here, and I can now paint. If I paint now, if I painted in a paintbrush here, then I say paint black, I can paint just the area that I want to paint, so I can just pull out that there. Remember, because I painted now, the background is stuck. But if I want to do anything else, I can change the blend mode and do other stuff with it. But I'm going to do that a different way. So let's start again. I'll leave the door selected now. So if you select first and then add a fill layer, look, it only fills in that area of the door. So this is selecting first and then putting the fill layer in afterwards. Now if I go to the blend modes and I go down to colour, what it's doing now is it's only taking the colour from the top layer and the tone, the black and white, the shades of it, the textures are from the background. So effectively I've got a colour change. And because I haven't painted on it as yet, if I move here, change the colours here, just go over the colour thing, then I've got a colour changer, which I can do dynamically. I can make it a bit lighter and make it darker and so on. So that's a quite neat way of doing that. One more thing I can do. I'm just going to take that and delete that again. And I'll just keep the selection here, but now I will invert the selection. So selection, invert pixel selection. So now I've got everything but the door selected. Now I'll put in another fill layer. And I'm going to make this fill layer black. And then go again down to the color blend mode. And what this does, because I've got a black background, effectively it's made it monochrome. So I can hit Control D to get rid of the marching ants there. Now what I've got a pop effect. Yeah, so this colour has come out here in everything else grey. So if you want to pop things, which is bring out one thing in colour, you can do it like that. And because I haven't painted anything on the background, I can still also do this. So I can do this in a tint. Yeah, and if I actually go to white or to black, it's still going to go monochrome. But I can just tint the background, do it in a complementary colour to the green, make that red, and hey, there we go, there's more effects. So that's a few of the things you can do by with his curious way of using a fill layer in a kind of mask. Anyway, hope that you enjoyed that, and thank you very much for watching.